Dude, you don't have to pay a masseuse. You have this seat going back, slapping your back. Oh my God, that was awesome, guys.
It's 10, platform 3, 15s. It's a fourth order. It's 2.5 to 1. It's got like 16 foot total sealed. I think it's like 40 foot ported. It's tuned to 43 or 44. There's two PSI Star Power 10K amps. I clamp about 10,500 per amp at 14 volts. I've got 154 amp hour C-Max battery. It's like a electric car battery. They're super high voltage the way they're wired up, and you can buy the banks, take them apart, put them back together, and they're like a 14 volt battery. It's just a nightmare. It beats itself apart. Like, you're always having to fix something. Blowing windshields every time you turn it on. I did a 163.5 and blew the windshield out the last time I metered it. We've just got Gorilla Tape on it, but we ran out, so we got to run more tape across it to keep glass out of everybody's eyes. It's just a struggle to keep it running. But other than that, I mean, it holds together pretty good. I've never rebuilt a sub. I've blown a couple amps, but it's just the way it goes. In each door, there's four DS18 8s. The center console, there's four more 8s, and there's two super tweeters in this console. Just got a couple little small four-channel amps running them. PSI stands for Pink Star Industries. You know, we run pink. That's our color, man.
even just a little bit. Just
testicle dropping, cherry popping.
That was like the whole song. I got you blocked here. Holy hell. I thought you were gonna give it like 30 seconds or something like that.
No, not for you, man.
Holy frig. Glass was going everywhere, dude. Like, seriously, it was flying. Like, quite literally, there was like layers of glass at different frequencies. There'd be like different positions of where it was coming at me. And you can see it. It's all the way back here, too. Oh, yeah. It's being sucked right back like a freaking vortex. This was just going absolutely nuts. Holy smokes. Look at this, he's even getting glass in his shoe. That's a prickly soul right there if I ever saw one.
Huge thanks to our friends at the Amp Lab for supporting the EXO channels. If you've got a busted up amp that needs repairing or just looking to buy new and used gear, be sure to check out the Amp Lab. Troy and Ethan are always hooking it up for us bass heads. Follow the link below. Now let's get back into it.
Masseuse, you have this seat going back, slapping your back. Oh my God, that was awesome, guys. It's like a heater blowing on me. They were smoking? They seem pretty healthy though.
Yeah.
They're taking it like a champion, dude. Well, there we have it, guys. Two more crazy car audio installs, fully exposed and demoed into the dirt. We started out with David Moore's 10 PSI 15s wreaking havoc on his shattered windshield. Glass was going everywhere, dude. It was flying. Man, too bad we can't just bust out our windshield and fix everything with TV's magic words.
Safe light repair, safe light replace.
Yeah, this stuff gets expensive. I mean, crap, just imagine how much money it would cost if every time you turn your stinking volume up, your damn windscreen blew out.
$160 every time, man. I've blown three of them in the last 2 weeks.
Whew, now I don't care who you are, that has got to sting. Spending $500 on shattering glass, most people would call that crazy, but most people on this channel would consider that all in good fun. And brings up a great comment from a fellow subscriber here. He says they should make windows for people who can turn it up without worrying if the glass will shatter. Well, luckily they do. It's just not terribly common for the daily ground pound crowd yet, but extreme SPL guys have been adding extra thick windows for quite some time now.
Take a look at that window. It's probably over an inch thick.
But interestingly enough, the extreme build style has been recently attracting more and more people from the musical style. So nowadays you'll see some extreme builds playing a full octave lower than what was most common just a handful of years ago. Pretty crazy too, the community just keeps pushing the limits, getting louder and lower, and I guess the only downside is the dangers of breaking glass and just about everything else in your ride. Then we hopped over to Sam's fourth order and played some bass lines lower than even Barry Manilow would want to go. I'm telling you, his subs were hitting so deep, it's like, what the hell? Who needs a massage parlor, right? Just show up in the dude's driveway with a handful of cash and be like, I've got back pain. Definitely a good time, and it was pretty cool seeing his custom-built DSS tridents from Mr. John Stucci. Nice job on the recones, man. Even though YouTube does a whole slaughter job on the audio quality, in real life, it sounds much better. All right, so now I'd like to close with a quick little one-on-one here. Topic being, the big new build. Where is it? What's the latest? Our buddy Henry here says, I miss your build videos and videos about what you're doing. I don't care about anyone else's builds. Oh, that's a shame. I subbed to see your stuff. Eh, that's just me though. Well, thank you so much for your feedback and your comment there, man. I hear what you're saying. You're probably wondering, hey, you just got that huge big van out there with a, you know, plans for a huge system. Where is it? Why hasn't it already started? Well, I guess I can start with, you know, things kind of came up that I didn't really expect, especially with having multiple project cars like Little Blue. The sub frickin' fell off the table, that set me back, as well as the additional steel stock investment set me back, and I'll be perfectly honest, tax season, that set me back, and there's been little tiny hurdles along the way after purchasing the car, which have, you know, probably led to your curiosity of why it hasn't been finished or started even. Well, there's a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff that goes on with huge builds like this, and being the lone wolf who has to fund it all, you know, I bought the amplifiers, bought those subs. Some of those subs I had to travel freaking 1,200 miles or even more just to get them in my possession. So I have all of the replacement parts, all the little doodads to make the system what it's going to be, but it takes time and patience. Even more so on my part, imagine what I'm going through over here. I'm like, ah! You know, going insane, especially with Little Blue being down right now. So if I could just maybe have a little bit of your support during this little kind of interim of like a little bit of gap. There's just a tiny gap. It was a little bit longer than anticipated, way longer than anticipated. But yeah, we're gonna be teaming up with someone who has great knowledge. We're gonna be getting our foot in the door with some new build tactics. So stay tuned, there's a lot coming in store. I just don't want you to be, you know, disappointed when you see these demo videos, because this is kind of where I started. I think I posted my first demo video of other people's cars in July of 2009. So that's 10 years this month. So when you think about it, this type of content that you saw in this video is right up our alley. You get to see all these awesome systems and it helps inspire people, not only myself, for the future. So if maybe you could see that in a different light where, yeah, you're seeing other people's systems right now, you want to see the big build that I got going on, and maybe even my Toyota, my Saturn. I have multiple project cars. I bit off a lot, you know, but it's a part of the fun. So if I can have some things on the back burner, which, you know, just so happened to take a little bit longer, it's still going full steam ahead. In fact, I've been getting little tiny things for the build along this whole process. I'm gonna try my hardest, my absolute hardest, these next couple few weeks to get all of the funds for the steel. Thousands, it's gonna be like $2,000 or more. Drop that and then the wood. That's gonna be very, very expensive because I'm getting the birch wood. And as you all know, they definitely don't give that stuff away. So we'll be going along with everything. So, all right, I'm going on too long here. I just wanted to touch base real quick and let everybody know that there's so much in store. It's just, you know, I'm just like you guys. I'm trying my best every day, and I wish it could go as fast as everyone wants it to be. So, all right, until the next one, thank you guys for your awesome support and being a member on Patreon. If you haven't checked it out, it's a little monthly thing we got going on. Awesome reward bonuses for you guys. We just did a huge 10 winner giveaway. We did a 5 winner giveaway. RCAs, fuses, voltmeters, tons of stuff, speakers, subwoofers. We give all kinds of stuff back to the community over there on Patreon. Just to say thank you for helping me be able to continue with these videos. So, and that also plays into the fact of, you know, making the build come sooner. So, all right, I will talk to you guys in the next video. This is EXO signing out. Thank you again so much. Your support means everything.